The plant shown here is Metasequoia glyptostroboides, quite a mouthful. The common name is dawn redwood. This tree is one that we call a living fossil because it was actually thought to be extinct. However, it was rediscovered in the 1940s by a plant exploration expedition to China. These two pictures clearly show the form of the dawn redwood, or Metasequoia glyptostroboides. The tree has a very tall, conical form. We could also say it's pyramidal. And while it takes it quite some time to reach this height, it can get up to 120 feet tall, but it preserves a strong central leader for the entirety of its growth, and again you can see that very conical shape to it. Here you can see the bark of the tree. It starts off a sort of reddish brown color and then with age becomes darker brown. It also exfoliates, or peels. And here you can really see close up how the bark peels and exfoliates in thin strips. So it's a different type of exfoliation than what you'd see on, say, a river birch. Here you can see the leaves of the dawn redwood. We refer to these types of leaves as linear leaves. So they're long, narrow leaves. They're flat rather than being three-dimensional. And a very important identification feature of the leaves is that they have opposite arrangement. Another tree that we'll cover in this course is Taxodium disticum, the bald cypress. It looks very similar to the dawn redwood, but the difference is that bald cypress has alternately arranged leaves, whereas, as you can see in both of these pictures, dawn redwood has opposite leaf arrangement. A good way to remember this is ABC, alternate bald cypress. So if it's alternate, it's bald cypress. If it's opposite, it's the dawn redwood. This picture shows the underside of the dawn redwood leaves. And the reason I've placed this picture here is so that you can see, although there is some faint banding on the underside of these leaves, it's not very distinct. Some of the other gymnosperms that we'll cover in this class have very distinct white stripes on the undersides of the leaves. Metasequoia lacks those. Here we see the fall foliage color for Metasequoia, and also here you can see the male cones hanging down in strands here on the right side of the picture. And again, more pictures of the male cones. So the male cones hang down in pendulous chains from the branches. They are very tiny and sort of a yellowish color. So they're about an eighth of an inch or less in diameter. And finally, we have the female cones. The female cones are distinctly larger than the male cones and are borne singularly instead of in pendulous chains. So you can see the shape is globular to almost barrel-shaped. A lot of the times, once the cones have fully matured, they're more of a barrel shape than a very perfectly round globe. These female cones are not yet fully ripened, so they're green. Once they mature and become fully ripened and ready to release their seeds, they'll be a dark brown color. And these cones are small, but much larger than the male cones. They're about a fourth of an inch in diameter. And that concludes our identification features for the dawn redwood, Metasequoia glyptostroboides, a very unique and beautiful gymnosperm.